Joining us now to talk about the spread of the coronavirus, Dr. Igor Koralnik. He's the chief of neuroinfectious diseases and global neurology at Northwestern Memorial Hospital. Doctor, thanks for joining us. Let's start with what we've learned since you were here the last time, which was a different point in time. It seemed like there was a lot more panic then, and we're learning a lot.
Micah and Joe, thanks for having me again. Always a pleasure to be here. So as you've heard from the governor, from the CDC, from other health officials, the situation is evolving daily. And there are more cases of infection that have been diagnosed in the US, and also some new case of community acquisition of the virus.
Should we be, you know, scared to death right now? I mean, that's all people are talking about everywhere you go. Don't travel, don't do this, wear masks. I mean,
don't shake hands.
Yeah, don't shake hands and things like that.
I shook hands with
you. Yes, you did.
Came, right? And so I think that it's okay to be concerned. Mm-hmm. It's better to be informed, but there's no reason to panic at this point, especially in Illinois or in area of the United States where cases have been so few and far between, and where proper measures of detection and containment are in effect.
Let's go to some of our viewer questions. We asked folks on Facebook if they had any questions for you, and here's one from Peggy, who asked, traveling within the U.S. via airplane, should I be worried or take any precautions?
Like you heard from the governor and from experts from the CDC, you should wash your hand regularly, cover your cough or sneeze if this happens. And if you're yourself sick or not feeling well, then you should not necessarily travel. Okay. But there's no reason to cancel travel within the
U.S. No reason. Within the U.S.
Exactly.
What about outside the U.S.?
The one caveat is that we need to listen to what's happening, for example, in Washington State, where you had 14 cases that have been diagnosed recently and a couple of fatalities, unfortunately. Outside of the U.S., there are some areas that have been recognized as high risk, including northern Italy, China, obviously, Iran,
South Korea,
and also parts of Japan. Mm-hmm. And so if you don't have, if you can cancel your travel there at this point in time, it's probably better to do so. Also, one of the risks is that if you go there, even if you're fine, then there may be problems for you to come back to the
U.S.
I
see. Okay, Brad on Facebook asks, how long does it live on surfaces?
So, it depends on the surface.
Okay.
We don't have a lot of data about the COVID-19. Based on the SARS and the MERS epidemic, we know that those viruses could remain about 9 days on different surfaces. Mm. What we know about copper and the metal for COVID-19 is about 2 hours.
Okay.
For other surfaces like cardboard and plastic, it may be longer than that. But these are not entirely known at this point. The risk of getting infected from a surface that comes through the mail, for example, package or letter, especially after several days at room temperature, is extremely low.
Right. Okay, so this is another one that many people have asked about. Lewis wrote on Facebook, will the virus go away as the weather warms up? It mimics the flu, and we know we have the flu season, which subsides a bit. Will that be the case with this?
That was the case also with the previous epidemic of SARS and MERS. Mm-hmm. For example, there were only 8,000 cases of SARS and 2,500 cases of MERS. And after that, an epidemic resurgence of resurgence of the virus depending on the season, right? Mm. We don't know yet for COVID-19 if it's going to carry out until the next season. At this point,
I was looking for our wipes that we wipe up here.
Oh, yeah.
Will that get rid of it if we wipe up before we sit down? Or?
Yes.
Okay.
If you use the wipe that can clean 99% of all the germs.
Okay. All right.
Yes.
Good. Thank you very much, sir.
Thanks, Doctor.
Appreciate
good to see you
it.
Again.
We have more information on the coronavirus outbreak at a special section of our website. We've also have a tool for you that tracks confirmed and suspected cases around the country. You can find it at WGNTV.com/coronavirus.